Now, all hands to quarters.
Sixth company, up, up.
Sixth company, report.
Diligence, cutter, all present account for.
Very well.
Sixth company, parade, rest.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our ceremony honoring Coast Guard Cutter Diligence's 50 years of continued service to the United States. I'm Lieutenant Commander Charlotte Mundy, Executive Officer of Coast Guard Cutter Diligence. I'll be your Master of Ceremonies this afternoon. All military personnel are to remain covered throughout the ceremony and follow my lead on rendering honors and salutes. Will guests please rise for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the presentation of colors. Ship's company, attention! Now, the Honorable Mike McIntyre, representative from North Carolina, arriving. Now, Honorable Bill Sappho, Mayor of the City of Wilmington, arriving. Now, Honorable Beth Dawson, New Hanover County Board, arriving. Now, Diligence, arriving. Color Guard, present the colors. Hand salute. Ready, two. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Ship's company, parade, rest. Coast Guard Cutter Diligence is the second of the Coast Guard's 16 210-foot Reliance-class medium-endurance cutters to enter the fleet. This class of cutters was the first vessel of any size to be built by the Coast Guard after World War II. Diligence was constructed in Houston, Texas, at Todd Shipyard for a cost of $4.9 million, and she was commissioned on August 26, 1964. Diligence was originally homeported in Key West, Florida, and patrolled the southern waters of the Atlantic and the Caribbean before moving to Cape Canaveral, Florida in 1983. Diligence remained in Cape Canaveral, Florida until 1990, when she was briefly removed from service to undergo a major maintenance and modernization period. In 1992, with all renovations complete, Diligence transferred home ports once again, moving to her new home in Wilmington, North Carolina, where she remains today, and is the only Coast Guard cutter homeported in the same location as its original Revenue Cutter Service namesake. Since Diligence's commissioning in 1964, she's been involved in nearly all of the Coast Guard's 11 statutory missions. Throughout the cutter's history, Diligence has prevented the flow of contraband and illegal migrants, from reaching the shores of the United States, protecting our nation's fisheries resources, and being involved in numerous search and rescue cases and protecting our homeland. Today, we honor Coast Guard Cutter Diligence, along with all of her past and present crew, for 50 years of commitment to operational excellence and loyal service to her nation. In the Coast Guard's proceedings article in 1965, Commander William Teague Jr. had the following to say about Reliance-class cutters. With their good seakeeping qualities, excellent maneuverability, helicopter handling facilities, and other modern features, these cutters are proven to be an extremely valuable addition to the Coast Guard's growing fleet of modern vessels. Diligence and her sister ships have proven Commander Teague correct over the last 50 years of service, and will continue to demonstrate the value of these ships as she stands the watch into the future. It is now my pleasure to introduce Representative Mike McIntyre from North Carolina's 7th District for his remarks.
Well, thank you so much. It's great to be with all of you today on this special day to celebrate this anniversary, and obviously with it being on this great day that we honor all who have served our country in uniform from all of our military branches as well. This city of Wilmington has had a long and rich history of maritime activities. None is more notable than the presence of the United States Coast Guard. As far back as 1792, Wilmington was home to the Revenue Cutter, one of the original 10 vessels that the U.S. Coast Guard had. In the 222 years that have followed, the Coast Guard has had an additional 14 cutters based in Wilmington. But as was indicated, none with the rich history and the steadfast longevity that this wonderful vessel has had. Wilmington has earned the distinction, which I was honored to present to this city and to the mayor and the wonderful citizens here back in 2003, as the first city on the East Coast of the United States to be named an official Coast Guard city in recognition of that long and wonderful history. And that recognition has to be renewed every 5 years. And so again in 2008 and then in 2013, we have renewed that designation. And I certainly hope, Mr. Mayor, and to the town council, to the city council and the county commissioners, that that designation will continue perpetually for years to come because of that wonderful relationship. The Coast Guard, indeed, with the history it has here, reminds me of the words of John Wesley, who was one of the great founders of the Methodist Church, and as a Presbyterian and one who also has had family who's Baptist and Pentecostal and some in-laws who are Catholic, I think it's only appropriate to stop and think about what it means when you have a ministry that touches lives. John Wesley once said, "Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, at all the times you can, as long as you can." Well, my friends, I think those words apply to these wonderful citizens who serve in the United States Coast Guard and to this wonderful vessel which serves our country. Let's give them a big hand and a big applause. Coast Guard motto, Semper Paratus, means always ready. Clearly, the Diligence has been diligent and has shown that through these 50 years. Clearly, all those who have served aboard her have shown that and have honored our country by wearing their uniform, which stands not only, of course, for the United States Coast Guard, but is a uniform of the United States of America. On the behalf of the United States Congress, I want to say thank you on behalf of a grateful nation for the service that you give to us. Those of you who have served aboard her and may be with us today, those who are currently serving aboard her, and to all who serve active reserve or who have served and are our veterans or retirees from the military, thank you for that service. Thank you for bringing this great designation to Wilmington. In making Wilmington, and I can tell you this from all that I hear up in Washington and have heard through the years, this is the most desirable Coast Guard place to be. And I know, Mr. Mayor, you and to our county commissioners, you're proud of that. I'm proud of it as your representative in the United States Congress that people know where Wilmington is. It's on the map and has been there because of this rich history. with the Coast Guard, and this is where those serving in our Coast Guard want to be assigned. And so many of our Coast Guardsmen obviously also retired. And we're thrilled to have the presence of the United States Coast Guard and what it means and what this history means. May God bless the Diligence, those who have served and do serve and will serve upon her. May God bless our United States Coast Guard and all those who serve our country this Veterans Day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Representative McIntyre. We're also pleased to have the mayor from the city of Wilmington, Mayor Bill Sappho, joining us today to share in this event with a few remarks.
I also want to say thank you to Congressman McIntyre for his public service to our region and our community in the United States Congress. You've done a lot for our community and for our region. I want to personally thank you for making us a Coast Guard city. And also, we were designated the first World War II city in America because of your efforts, and also with the commissioning of the USS North Carolina submarine, as well as the USS Gravely. Thank you very much. You know, I've said this before and I'll say it again. Jacksonville's got the Marines, Fayetteville's got the Army, Goldsboro's got the Air Force, but I've got the United States Coast Guard. And that is a lot. You can complain about a lot of things in government, but one thing you can't complain about is the USS Diligence. We have gotten our money's worth out of this ship. It was 4 years old, it was commissioned, and if you think about it, just across the way, the U.S. North Carolina was only in active duty for about 4 years, 4 or 5 years. So we have gotten our money's worth, but more importantly, we've gotten a tremendous amount of service from these young men and women that defend our coastline and defend our country, and we appreciate that. So on behalf of all of the citizens of Wilmington, congratulations on your 50th anniversary. I also want to recognize my city council, Mayor Pro Tem Margaret Haynes, and council member Laura Padgett, as well as Senator Michael Lee, and as well as Representative Susie Hamilton, and as well as council member Kevin O'Grady, the Irishman. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Savo. It's now my pleasure to introduce Ms. Beth Dawson, Vice President of the New Hanover County Commissioners.
Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be with you all this afternoon. And I was just remembering I had the distinct privilege of joining Commander Randall and the crew of the Diligence as she returned into home port. Back in the winter, we went out to Oak Island, from Oak Island to the mouth of the Cape Fear, and had the distinct privilege of going aboard and coming into home port. It was a very cold day, but you all did a great job, and it was great to meet so many folks. On behalf of your New Hanover County Board of Commissioners, Chairman Woody White, Commissioner Tom Wolf, and Commissioner Jonathan Barfield and myself, it is an honor to present the New Hanover County Coast Guard Cutter Diligence Week Proclamation. Whereas the United States Coast Guard Cutter Diligence was originally commissioned on August 26, 1964, as the second ship in the 210-foot Reliance class of Coast Guard cutters. Since commissioning, Diligence has been homeported in Key West, Florida, and Cape Canaveral, Florida, and since 1992 has called Wilmington, North Carolina, home port. Whereas the current Coast Guard Cutter Diligence is the sixth Coast Guard cutter to bear this name, and also shares the name and mooring location as one of the original 10 cutters of the Revenue Marine, which Congress authorized Secretary of the Treasury Alexander Hamilton to create on August 4, 1790. And whereas the Coast Guard Cutter Diligence is an active participant of the United States Coast Guard, the country's premier maritime safety and marine law enforcement agency, a versatile branch of the armed forces and one of our country's most productive agencies. And whereas the Coast Guard Cutter Diligence has faithfully honored the United States Coast Guard's motto, Semper Paratus, by providing exceptional service to the citizens of the United States of America for the past 50 years and to the citizens of New Hanover County for 22 years. And whereas Wilmington, North Carolina was the first city on the East Coast to receive the honor of being designated as a Coast Guard city in 2003 and was recertified in 2008 and 2013. Whereas during these 50 years of service, the Coast Guard Cutter Diligence has been responsible for strategic interdictions preventing thousands of illegal migrants and tons of illegal narcotics from reaching our shores, and actively participated in Coast Guard operations to protect our U.S. shores, including but not limited to search and rescue operations, saving hundreds of lives, countless law enforcement inspections to protect our fisheries resources, prevent acts of terrorism, and ensure boating safety. And whereas this 11th day of November, Veterans Day, is a fitting day to celebrate and reflect upon all of the exemplary contributions to the citizens of this nation and New Hanover County of all current and former crew members of Coast Guard Cutter Diligence and the families that have served alongside of them. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed by the New Hanover County Board of Commissioners that November the 8th through November the 15th be recognized as Coast Guard Cutter Diligence Week in New Hanover County on the 50th anniversary celebration of its service to our nation and the 22nd anniversary of service to New Hanover County. Adopted on the third day of November 2014, New Hanover County Woody White Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Dawson. It's now my pleasure to introduce Commanding Officer Cutter Diligence, Commander Jeff Randall.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for coming out today. Raise this up. Fortunately, we got lucky. This morning, I was a little concerned. I thought we were going to this might be a wet event, but it looks like it's and not the Wilmington Harbor Enhancement Trust type of wet, but the actual precipitation out of the sky event. But anyway, we're very lucky that it dried up. We have a wonderful day to have this event here. Thanks for coming out and celebrating our final event that we have for the Diligence 50th Anniversary Weekend. As you know, as you've heard, our original commission date was August 26, 1964. Unfortunately, during that time, we were at the Coast Guard Yard at Curtis Bay, Maryland. They were running a little behind, so we ended up having to push this event back to Veterans Day. And it's probably actually more fitting that we actually do this event on Veterans Day, because not only is it appropriate to recognize a ship that's provided 50 years of service to the nation on Veterans Day, but it's also important to recognize those people who have served aboard the Cutter Diligence and are currently serving aboard Diligence on this Veterans Day. Congressman McIntyre, Mayor Sappho, and Ms. Dawson, thanks so much for being part of our official program today. I know your schedules are very busy on Veterans Day, and there are many demands on your time. So thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules for coming and being part of this event today. We also have a very long list of elected and appointed officials who have joined us today. We have Senator Michael Lee, Susie Hamilton, Mr. Cruz from the great state of North Carolina, as well as several members from the Wilmington City Council and the New Hanover County Commissioners. I know that you guys all have, and ladies, all have a very busy schedule today, so thank you also for coming out. No better place in the city of Wilmington to celebrate an event like this than in a and been in a Coast Guard city. Also want to extend a welcome and thank you to all the former crew members, the families of those former crew members, and the former Diligence commanding officers who are in attendance today. We have several of them, and I tell you, one of the things that's been wonderful about this past weekend is I've met so many people who have served on board this ship in the past, and the stories and the rich history they bring forward have been truly impressive to hear. For those of you who are going to be around afterwards, there's a whole collection of memorabilia that we have up on board the cutter in my cabin there. 50 years of history, and it's pretty impressive to see some of the accomplishments of this ship over the time. Veterans Day, as I mentioned, is a fitting way to recognize the service of Diligence, as well as those crew members who have served aboard. And while many know a little bit about Coast Guard history and the history of the Coast Guard in the city of Wilmington, and we also know that the Revenue Cutter Diligence, one of the original 10 cutters, was more homeported here, many in the city simply know the cutter as Diligence, but others know it as Diligence 6 because it is, in fact, the sixth ship with this name. And as we mentioned before, it's the only one that still occupies one of the original home ports of the Revenue Cutter that is its namesake. As I look back through the 50 years, and we have several photo albums up there, and we started flipping through the first couple of the photo albums over the last 6 months. We have photo albums from the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, and even a few from the 2000s. And it was interesting to go back through all those photo albums. There aren't any words that necessarily go with the pictures, but like they say, a picture tells a thousand, a picture's worth a thousand words. And as you look back through those pictures, it's easy to see that this cutter has a very rich history. For these efforts, over the past 50 years, Diligence has received, by our count, 8 Coast Guard unit commendations, 8 Coast Guard meritorious unit commendations, and numerous other campaign awards. And since being delivered from the Todd Shipyards in Houston, Texas in 64, and having been homeported in Key West, Cape Canaveral, and before coming to Wilmington, she's been involved in 42 marijuana seizures, 8 cocaine seizures, repatriated thousands upon thousands of migrants interdicted at sea, executed hundreds of fishing vessel inspections to protect our nation's fishery surface resources, both before and after the implementation of the Magnuson-Stevens Act, made multiple transits through the Panama Canal, skillfully executed numerous search and rescue cases. The ships hosted numerous heads of states, including George Bush, 41, and popular singers such as Jimmy Buffett, and have been involved in at least 3 major motion pictures. These are all little small facts that nobody would necessarily know unless you start going back through the pages of history on board this cutter. What an amazing return on investment, and to the nation and to the public, on the Coast Guard's initial investment of $5 million in this cutter. As I said at the start, I want to take a few moments with each of you today to share some of this rich history that we learned over each of the decades. Some of this history I've learned only recently, thanks in part to many of the former crew members who are in the audience, and especially Captain Keyes, right back there with the Vietnam veteran's hat. Captain Keyes was one of the original crew members on board the Cutter Diligence when she was commissioned in 1964. As you know, as we mentioned before, Diligence was the second cutter in the Reliance-class fleet, originally designated as WPC-616, as Captain Keyes so adeptly pointed out to me upon our first meeting. An early article about the Reliance-class cutters said, with their helicopter landing features and improved habitability features, these cutters mark a definite change in the concept of vessel construction and utilization in the Coast Guard. And at the time of her commissioning, Diligence was indeed considered to be a modern vessel. 50 years later, we're trying to keep her modern. And this was especially the case in comparison to many of her Coast Guard cutter counterparts who had seen service during World War II. My first ship that I reported to back in 1993, had also seen service in World War II. In her first decade of service, America had become increasingly wary of the communist threat that lay to her south in Cuba. As that Cold War was heating up, Diligence performed service as part of the Cuban patrol that kept a close eye on the communist threat in Cuba. She recovered hundreds of Cuban refugees fleeing Fidel Castro's rule in Cuba. She was involved in the successful recovery of the Gemini 3 space capsule carrying astronauts Gus Grissom and John Young. According to the story, Diligence saw the capsule descending towards Earth on her radar and had her helicopter on scene just 9 minutes after splashdown, but was ordered to remain clear of the capsule by the Navy, who has never admitted to this day that they were upstaged by the Coast Guard. While home boarded in Key West, Diligence was also part of the movie, Around the World, Under the Sea. That was her first movie premiere. Then in the 70s, Diligence expanded her operations beyond her initial concept of operations to include search and rescue, to include more law enforcement operations as marijuana smuggling became a new trend in the Straits of Florida. Throughout the 70s, Diligence was involved in numerous marijuana seizures. There are several pictures up in the cabin of crew members, and I know we wouldn't do this today, but reaching their hands down into the bags of marijuana and holding them up for the pictures. Somehow I know that quite wouldn't fly today. In addition, she was involved in a notable cruise search and rescue case involving the cruise ship Cunard Ambassador, just 20 miles south of Key West. The Cunard Ambassador caught fire, and Diligence, along with other cutters, including the White Sumac, responded to assist with firefighting and rescue efforts. At the end of the day, Diligence and the other cutters involved helped rescue more than 300 persons from the cruise ship, as well as providing firefighting response to put out the fire on board. Later in the decade, the cutter Diligence was visited by the same famous singer, Jimmy Buffett, whose picture, with a Diligence hat on his head, appeared on the cover of Rolling Stone magazine. Moving into the 80s, Diligence continued her involvement in search and rescue and law enforcement. Early in the decade, Diligence supported the U.S. government's efforts to stem the flow of Cuban migrants into the United States as part of the Mariel boat lift. It was also during the 80s that Diligence had her first change of home port from Key West to Cape Canaveral. And throughout the remainder of the 80s, Diligence assisted with stopping the flow of illegal migrants and narcotics into the southern Florida. Diligence began the 1990s at Curtis Bay, Maryland. It was there, as you heard, that she underwent the major renovation and overhaul that's made the ship what it looks like today. The stacks, or the exhaust going out the stern was removed, the stacks were added, the flight deck was changed, the boat hoisting and davits were also rearranged. Upon departing Curtis Bay, the cutter changed home ports for a third time to its new home of Wilmington, North Carolina. As a primary drug threat was impacting the United States was shifted from marijuana to cocaine, Diligence participated in Operation Vista, where she transited to the Eastern Pacific via the Panama Canal to perform counter-narcotics missions at sea and humanitarian missions ashore. She also participated in Operations Able Manner and Able Vigil to stem the flow of persons attempting to enter the United States by maritime routes and repatriating thousands of migrants back to the countries of Cuba, Haiti, and the Dominican Republic. Then in the 2000s, Diligence then supported operations following 9/11, providing a critical command and control platform in New York Harbor, as well as providing a reassuring presence to the maritime public and to deter any further attacks. Diligence also provided waterside security for President Bush number 41 and other members of the Bush family during a family cruise to the Bahamas. In fact, a picture from President Bush's visit proudly hangs on the mess deck bulkhead today. In the 2000s, Diligence also began deploying with Coast Guard Hitron helicopters and was responsible for numerous cocaine seizures in the deep Caribbean. It was also during this decade that Diligence was able to help support the city of Wilmington's efforts to become the first city on the East Coast to be designated a Coast Guard city. And while the history of the current decade is still being written, Diligence has continued her proud tradition of service. In this decade alone, Coast Guard Cutter Diligence has earned 2 Coast Guard Meritorious Unit Commendations for participation in Operation Trade Winds and Operation Ocean Hunter. Diligence has continued to protect the United States from threats delivered from the sea, those on the sea, and protect the sea itself. Diligence has also continued to repatriate hundreds of migrants addicted to sea, at sea and stem the flow of illegal narcotics into the United States. We've performed hundreds of commercial fishing vessel inspections to protect vital fish stocks and prevent illegal fishing activity along the eastern seaboard. It's without question that the Diligence has capably served this nation's Coast Guard and government for the past 50 years. The stories I've recounted above are just a few of the highlights from our 50 years of service. And it's truly been an honor for me to be part of this historic event on occasion of her anniversary. This ship has a proud history and a promising future, and will continue to serve the nation and the maritime community until such time as this ship is eventually replaced by the Coast Guard's offshore patrol cutter. Until that time, we'll continue living the ship's motto of courage, honor, and tenacity. Thanks largely to the past contributions and forward thinking of those crew members who have served aboard this cutter. While many of them are in the audience today, I'd like to now take a moment to publicly recognize those former commanding officers, as well as Captain Keyes, one of the original plank owners who are in attendance today, whose leadership has enabled Diligence to reach this historic milestone. There's about 13 of these ships left in the class. Some of them are a little much tougher shape than what the Diligence is today. And it's only because of people like Captain Keyes and the other former commanding officers who have come before me, through their leadership and efforts, is this ship probably in the best shape of any Coast Guard 210 in the entire inventory. Four of our fellow 210s had to go to emergency dry dock this year for structural issues. When we took Diligence to Curtis Bay, the engineers came aboard and said, "This ship is impressive. We have not seen a ship this old in this good a condition." So I would ask Mr. Imant, Mr. Cascardi, Mr. Daniels, Mr. Keyes, if you guys come up forward, I'd like to present each of you one of our special 50th anniversary commemorative coins for your service and leadership on board Diligence. Conclude my remarks. Thank you very much, everyone, for coming today. It's great that we have a standing room only crowd for such a historic event. God bless America. God bless all our veterans, and Semper Paratus.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the retirement of colors and the departure of the official party. Ship's company, attention. Coast Guard, retire the colors. Hand salute. Ready, two. Now, the Honorable Mike McIntyre, representative from North Carolina, departing. Now, Honorable Bill Sappho, Mayor of the City of Wilmington, departing. Now, Honorable Beth Dawson, New Hanover County Board, departing. Now, Diligence, departing. This concludes our 50th anniversary ceremony. Please take time to enjoy the tour of a ship, refreshments, and conversations with past and present crew members of Coast Guard Cutter Diligence during the reception at the tent located at the far end of the parking lot. And thank you again very much for joining us today. Ship's company.